Well, hello everybody and welcome back to another video. This time we're going to be playing Truck Life, a simulator based on Euro Truck Simulator by SCS. It's a Chinese development game and we should be driving on the Chinese map. So if we click single player, there's my save, Stringbean 001, confirm. I've played 2 hours at the moment. Oh, with any luck, I've opened up multiplayer. I've got 2 vehicles at the moment. That's the current money I have in the bank, 69,283. I've done 6 quests already. You've got 1, 2, 3, several save slots. We're going to load the first. Right, here we are. So let's have a look. I click garage. This is a truck I'm currently driving. There's quite a few that need to be unlocked. Now I do seem to have a bit of a problem with this at the moment. If I use the slider bar to come all the way down, you can see it starts to glitch out. And then I can't... Yeah, you see I get a lot of this weird, strange glitching. The only way to get out of it is to come back to do this. But anyway, so I own this truck. You start off with the default, which is, hey, you see now I can't get back up there. The only way is to use the mouse wheel, which is a lot slower. So you start off with this truck, the Jingwei, as your default truck. And then obviously, the more you save up, you can buy other trucks. You've got various others to unlock. This is the one I've got at the moment. Settings. Game settings, broadcasts, looks like you can add music to music files to play, and this is where you'll get your jobs from. So what we'll do first of all, and show you the rest, did I? Graphic settings, full screen mode, resolution, graphic quality. It looks like it's blanked out, I don't know why. But everything's on full V-Sync, anti-aliasing. You've got your audio settings. Input settings. So I'm using my Logitech G29 wheel. I'm using the H-Shifter. And there we are, input device settings. You've got your keyboard, your mouse. Whatever your wheel is on that one. You can pick simple automatic, real automatic, H-shifter manual. So I'm using H-shifter manual, and you've got your other input choices there. So without further ado then, let's click start. Side view. So this is a truck I bought recently. There's my number plate, Stringbean 001. I don't know what the S stands for, I can't remember, at the front of the number plate there, at the back of it. So, let's go and see what jobs are available from here. Quickly show you the map. I can't zoom out any further by the looks of it, but this is the Chinese route map. You've got practically the whole lot. I think they are expanding with more cities in the future, but there's quite a lot to choose from. I don't know what scale the map is. I don't believe it's 1.1. Where am I? Here we are. So I'm here at a place called Jinhua. This is where you'll go and eat. Where you'll sleep is where you fill up with your fuel. And 4S, the icon there, is where you would buy your trucks, upgrade your trucks. Now you do get hungry in this game. Unlike Eurotruck, you do get hungry in this game, so you've got to eat. You've got to sleep. Okay, let's jump inside. Here we are, quite nice inside. Let's start the engine by pressing the I key. I do find the engine's not quite so loud when I start driving. Okay. Pressing down on the accelerator doesn't rev the engine up, despite me being manual. Unless I put it in first. I do like the fact that the gear stick changes, as you can see, with the gears. Third, fourth, back to neutral. Okay, parking brake off, which is the space bar. Okay, let's use the shifter into first, clutch in, let's go. Now it doesn't support track IR, not yet anyway. I don't know if it will be implemented. So again, using the mouse. Okay, let's see what jobs we've got. Now if you look in the bottom right corner, you've now got check the quest link. Pick up the quest. In other words, pick up your job. Press enter to confirm. So we're now going to press enter. Right. That's where we are. You can see the little purple dot. I don't know if I can zoom in. No, I don't seem to be able to zoom in, but that's where we are. What you do here with this game, let's take a long journey here to Mount, yeah, whatever that says. Oh, it's not allowing me to take that job, I don't think. Oh yes it is, right. Yeah, so you pick your destination first, wherever you want to go. Like you want to go there, you want to go there, it'll automatically put the line in. We're going to go here, and then you select your job. Once you've selected here, then your vehicles that you own will become selectable. So remember that sequence. You pick, you've got your destination, you pick where you want to go, and then you pick the jobs that are available on that route. So let's see which pays the most. We've got 218 292. Oh look, we're going to be taking steering wheels and pedals and H-shifters. Yeah, so we'll take that. Accept request on that track. Right. Do you want it to load automatically? Do you want to go to the loading area? Give up. Well, we'll go to the loading area. Yep. So, let's go then. Oh, I didn't get my truck that I wanted, my green truck. I didn't get the truck that I wanted. Oh well. I thought I selected the truck that I wanted. I'm annoyed about that. I wanted my green truck. Never mind. Can't be bothered to change it all now. Right, press T to pick up the cargo. So, deliver to Wuyi A Speciality Wholesale Centre. There we are. Look at that, we've got our steering wheels. There's a great shortage of those at the moment. Right, okay, let's get inside, let's go. Oh, before we do, if you look at the you look at the icons down the right here, this is our fuel, so you can see the depletion will start to disappear there. This icon is for your food stats. I think that's if you need to repair your truck. I'm not quite sure on that one yet. And this is when you get hungry. So we might see those in action during the journey. You can get rid of this whole thing if it annoys you, just simply by pressing the Z key, and then pressing Z again. Okay. So first gear. Space bar for parking brake. In order to get rid of the mouse icon, so that we can steer with the mouse, or view with the mouse, simply press F5. Now we can move. Driving has a lot more improvement needed. As soon as you take your foot off the accelerator, you practically stop. Where are we going now? So, E. I do like the countdown on the traffic lights. Right, right turn. Well, at least the speedometer works. The driving physics are practically non-existent at the moment. Made it. The scenery is very sparse. Oh, we're turning here. Right. Yeah, it's... The steering, I mean the acceleration is like practically all or nothing. I think we'll get some fuel. Yeah, let's get some fuel. Handbrake on, engine off. Let's get out of the car, out of the van. Yep. You can get out and have a walk around. I think you can only go so far. Yeah, and then it puts you back in the car. Back in the vehicle, so you can't go far. It's not like the open world. Okay, so we walk into here. Press enter to fill up the car. Filled up. Wow, I must be wearing hobnail boots. Okay, let's get back in. F. if you look at the fuel icon now, it's fully circled. Let's go. I'll just show you the map. So that's where we are at the moment. Okay, I don't know if you can see my mouse icon there on the recording. You can see we're in the centre there. We're going to be travelling. Wow, long journey. Long journey. Through the toll booth. If you go faster than the speed limit allows, then she'll tell you off on the GPS. There we've got a bit of a bug going on there. Game is still in development, and from what I've read on their Discord channel and other comments, that they do plan to update this over the next 10 years, so we'll see what they bring to the table. But if you're like me and you like driving simulators, I think you'll enjoy this. I certainly enjoy it. Get a good drive. Steering wheel works, that's the main thing. Whoop, yep, see, she told me off there. 100 miles. At least the steering wheel works. Well, the Logitech G29 does anyway. That's what I'm using. The pedals and the H-shifter. So, you know. At least I don't have to use an Xbox controller or my keyboard. Just need track IR. I like jumping into these other driving games. It's just that it makes a change from Euro Truck, American Truck, you know. I just like the change. I quite enjoy driving games. Nice bit of gear change there. It's just that when you start off in gear 1, change to gear 2, it's a bit clunky. Hope our steering wheels haven't fallen off the back. give you an outside view in a second. Take that popping and redrawing of scenery in front of you. I've got everything on ultra. Don't want to lose control. Go a bit slower. Better get inside and out for this. Whoops, 80 miles, 80 kilometres an hour I should say. So yeah, we're getting a very nice drive out of this. Turning off shortly. Go on, son. Oh, God help us. Whoops. Getting hungry. We'll try and get a nice pot noodle or some fried rice somewhere. Yum yum. Oh, this looks nice. station. As soon as you take your foot off the accelerator, even just a little bit, you've practically come to a stop. It's kind of a bit awkward when clutching. Come on. Went into second gear. Didn't like it. Really? Looks like their indicators don't work. Oh, I'm in second gear. I wondered why I was going a bit slow. On the outside view. Wow, this is a windy road. Speed limit then. Windy road. Wow, look at those mountains being drawn in front of me. I hate that. Well, those vehicles in front look like they're going much faster than 60. I wonder what it is with AI in these driving games. They can go faster than you. You're not allowed to keep up with them. sharp bend. Oh, I bet this is good coming up in the night time. Now when you go past the red traffic light, you do get fined. It's always nice when you can drive amongst other traffic, you know, just cruise with them. Right. If I saw a sign there saying 80 kilometres, how come? Yeah, look, is it 80? 80 maximum along this road. But we can only... Oh, now it's changed to 80 now. We can get to fourth gear now. Oh, not too high. I hope we find a restaurant soon. Somewhere to eat. It was just the one box we had on the back, wasn't it? There's old Bill on the corner. Okay, 60. How are we doing for fuel? Where is the fuel? There. I'm going to top up. Got it. Just in case. run out. Point 6 liters, 48. What's that, yen? How far can we walk? We can walk over there. We can walk round the forecourt. Bang! Straight inside. You can only go so far. Right. Where are we on the map? Let's have a look. So we've got to turn back round from here and back round. So we've done halfway. Halfway. Toll booth. There's a lot of toll booths in China. I like the way they open. Go.
祝您一路顺风。
Unlike Eurotruck, I don't think there's a time limit on the jobs. Not in the few that I've done, as far as I'm aware. God, I miss my track IR. Really do. Well, we're getting a very good drive, guys, aren't we? Seriously. I just don't like the popping in of the scenery in front. Is that something to do with Unity engine? Slowing down. The traffic behaves pretty well. Then again, there isn't a great deal of it to cause much issue. He keeps telling me off, going too fast. That's because the acceleration, it's all up the wall, seriously. needs a lot of work doing to it. Oh, look at that road in the distance, guys. There's nothing there, it's just been drawn. I don't like that at all. I mean, graphically, and this is my personal opinion, it feels like I'm playing on an iPad, you know? A bit iPad-ish. Very basic scenery. Very sparse. It would really suit for an iPad.
Whoa!
Well, he did slow down, didn't he? You saw that. I've got witnesses. He slowed down, there was no need. I hope he didn't damage the steering wheels in the back. He slowed down, right in front of me. We're on the motorway. What are you slowing down for? Yeah, well, I'm getting past you now. Winding me up now. No force feedback, I'm not feeling any of the little road bumps or anything like that. Oh, bloody hell.
你已超速.
you know, I don't mean to keep going above the speed limit. It's the acceleration physics. It kind of just runs away with you from time to time. Oh God, look, we're getting hungry. Oh, we should have turned off there and got something to eat. Damn. Should have turned off. Turning off. You can bring up the internal mirrors. I think it's one of the F1 buttons. Oh, F3, there we go. You can have the internal mirrors. Oh, too fast. We are getting hungry. Wow, look at that van go straight through. put your lights on. Right, let's just check out the map. There are no places to eat. Well, none of them have got their lights on. It looks sort of daylight. I'm keeping them on, they're looking pretty dark. Now, we don't want an accident around here. And we're stuck behind a bus. Already had one collision, I don't want to risk overtaking. Well, we're up in the mountains. What are those green things? What are those green things? Chinese lanterns. Look, there's more in front of us. Is it just a lighting glitch? It's weird how they're in little clusters. Loads of them. That was interesting. Oh, there's more of them. They seem to be in little clusters. There's some down there, look. Oh, we've arrived at our destination. Okay, here we go. We made it. Right, so we've reached the destination, finished the quest, and press enter to confirm. Now I can't kind of look behind me, so green. Yep, there we go. Right, press T to unload the cargo. Right. Oh, look, cargo damage punishment 424. That's that car that slowed down on the motorway and I hit him from behind. So everybody that's going to get their steering wheels for their computers, going to be a few returns coming back. Bonus. Gas consumed, delivered. Mileage 640 kilometres. That was a good drive. And there we are. Yep. I hope I can survive until I get to, here we are, Nanping. Maybe we'll do that on the next one. Do that together, see if we can survive from Mount Wuyai all the way around to Nanping, and we can get something to eat, fill up with petrol, and maybe pop into the shop, have a look at some vehicles, and we might even need to have a sleep. So we've got the sleep icon there as well. So got a lot more cities to explore. That was a long journey. There's loads more of it. Look, we're only up there. There's loads. Right, let's get out of that. Turn my lights off. That's where we should leave it. I'm going to stay here for the night. Turn my lights off, no? Okay. Right. So, vehicle situation 94%, gas remaining 75%. Well, we'll leave it there then, guys, until the next one. Bye for now.